So one of the things I experience a lot when I'm working with clients is tight hamstrings. Those muscles that run through the back of the thigh and across the back of the knee. And it prevents people from feeling easy in their movements sometimes. And tight hamstrings can affect the lower back as well. So it's important that we try to stretch effectively and efficiently. So that's what we're going to work on today. So I have here a strap, just a yoga strap. You could use a belt or a band if you have a band, just something that's going to give you a little bit of resistance if you need it. So lay yourself carefully down for that. Just to begin with, just pull your right knee into your chest. Keep the left leg bent for a moment. Feel that right side of the back flatten down gently. And just feel a little stretch just come across the back of the hip and buttock. If that feels a bit tight, just move it a little wider so it's not quite onto the belly. And then release and change sides. So bring the knee in. Just press it in, you'll feel a little bit of a pull through the back line of the body. If you're not comfortable holding across the shins, feel free to hold behind the thigh, it doesn't matter. And again, if you need to, just moving it to the side. Try not to twist, we're just pulling in to start our stretch. And release. Place the feet carefully down to the floor, have your strap handy if you need it. And then pull the right knee back into the chest, hold behind the thigh this time. And then from where you are, just begin to straighten the leg out, breathing out. And as you breathe in, soften. So it doesn't matter if the back's flat. As you breathe out, just begin to open up through the back of the knee and then breathe in and release. So nice and easy, keep it smooth. Now your leg might be nowhere near your thigh, in which case you might want to put your strap, your belt, whatever it might be, behind the thigh, relax the arms down so it's here perhaps, and then you could straighten and release. Okay, so you could do that if you wanted to. You might even feel your legs even further forward, maybe you're very tight in your hamstrings. So wherever it is, don't force it, don't bounce it, just keep it very rhythmic. And then take the leg up and just hold it there. So we would be looking to aim for a nice straight leg, so you can see my leg's a little straight there. But you might still be working with a bit of a bent knee, and maybe this feels like you're at your end point. Stick with it, consistent practice will help. So as you breathe out, just flex the foot and breathe in, release. Breathe out, flex, breathe in, release. So if your knee's bent, still work on the flex and the point. If you want to straighten the leg, you might need to take it further forward. So you're aiming, the point is that you're aiming for the straightest leg that you can work with. So whether it's slightly angled forward and you're holding it with the strap, or whether you're quite flexible and you're holding it with the hands, doesn't matter. Okay, so either using the hands or the strap, relax the foot, take a breath in, and as you breathe out, bring the leg just a little bit closer, drop the shoulders down, and then brace the upper body as you press your leg into your hands or into the strap. So you feel like you're trying to push your leg forward, but your hands are preventing it. Try to keep the jaw relaxed, try to keep the shoulders relaxed. Take a breath in, and as you breathe out, relax that tension, let the leg come a little bit closer to you. So we're still looking for a straightish knee, okay? Let's do that one more time. Take a breath in. As you breathe out, brace the hands, draw the shoulders down, try and press the leg away. It's like you're trying to really, really fire the leg away from you. It's a little bit of personal PNF stretching. You might see my leg shaking a little bit with the effort. So you're pushing your leg away, you're pulling back with the hands. Take a breath in. As you breathe out, bring the leg a little bit closer. Has it come any closer? It probably has, to be honest. So take a few breaths there. Really again, looking for the length through the back of the leg. And then release. Put the leg back down. Give the leg a little shake out. You might even want to stretch out the legs and release the hip. Give the legs a bit of a shake. And then bend the knees. And do the whole thing again on the other leg. It may feel different on the other side. And it doesn't really matter if it does, but consistent practice will really help to release the hamstrings.